What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. I'm gonna be editing some like pretty simple portraits today. Shouldn't be too hard, so let's go ahead and get into this. Let's see what these pictures are. Or maybe I didn't import them yet. Hold on. What I'm gonna do first is delete this entire folder. Top of my TV. Oh no, I wanna delete everything. Let me get the whole thing gone. Select range. I'm selecting all these. I haven't gotten paid for any of them yet, so these aren't getting edited. Delete all of them. Alrighty, that should clear up some space on my Lightroom. I don't think I ever imported these pictures I want to edit. Megan. Devin is my Brianna. Nope, I haven't imported it yet, so crap. I feel really bad for not remembering this girl's name. And I kinda wish I did. I know her Instagram handle though, so I'm just gonna go by that. I actually feel really bad I don't remember this girl's name. Okay, this we created. Let's go ahead and add some pictures. What's in my camera roll? Oh yeah. Okay, so these ones. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do I have any more? But I did. There's 4 of them? Alright, so whoops. So we're doing 4 pictures. Let's add these 4. I'm actually gonna start rotating this one. I need to fix that in my camera. I actually like these a lot, just because they're like really simple. I think I started editing this one. Whoa. What do my colors look like that? Maybe. Yeah. I did start editing this one. I didn't like that at all. They are not. What the mess? Okay, this one's not too bad. So I like this one. What I usually do most times, which I haven't been like showing, is I go through and like star my pictures based on the ones I like, just so I can keep track of them. Oh, come on. And it usually just helps me when I have like when I'm going through like 150 pictures and I want to narrow it down to like my top 5. What I normally do is I just go through and I normally just go through and just let me out my top 5 that I starred, and then I just turn my filter on and click the star button and click it all the way to 5. That's why I usually, you know, rate my favorite pictures, and that's how you just usually how I like weed them out. But from here, I'm gonna go to my preset, go ahead and open this up and copy. Okay, that's copied. Let's go back to ice blue. Now, let's go ahead and paste that. Seem to turn my brightness up, it's killing me. Alright, lighting. this needs to be brightened up.
My highlights are a little high.
Won't be too much skin retouching, it doesn't look like. I'm trying to get our colors right in our face. Let's go to orange. I think the orange is too saturated. Let's bring it down a little. Or zero. Let's see what happens. I don't want to lose color. Which isn't a bad thing, but what I normally want to try and do is make sure the color is even around her face, just so it doesn't make editing the picture later a tougher task. Before, after, she looks a little pale, I'm not gonna lie. With the light, and I can turn the palette's down, white's already down. It's like a common thing with me, is I go to edit pictures and having my glasses on makes a huge difference. Not because I'm blind or anything, but just so I can see the colors a lot better. Also helps when I have a light on so I can see what I'm doing. I'm just gonna leave this mic over. Okay. Let's see. Actually, I don't think about it. Let me make sure my notifications are off. There you go, stirs on. Sweet. Now, let's get back to this picture. Let me try the next one. Because sometimes my settings, okay, it's too dark, obviously. This one's not too bad. Maybe that's what we need to do to the last one. I still think the orange is too much. Photo. Okay, I'm going to duplicate. Open up your layers just so you can see them. I wonder if this works. I'm going to put this in its own folder. Here and just add this frequency separation just so it's already in a folder when it separates. Thank you. gonna put the frequency separation on and stretch. Cause I've been sitting here all day. Now let's get back to the picture. Make sure it did separate out. Turn high frequency off and just focus on skin. Her skin's actually not bad at all. Get my patch tool. The one thing I'm gonna focus on with skin retouching is just blending their face and getting rid of regular blemishes. I hate calling them blemishes though, because they're not really like imperfections. I'm not fixing their bad skin, I'm just making their skin how I think it should look like. Before it never looked that bad. I just got rid of some of the pimples. Her nose is a little splotchy, so I don't know if you can tell, but like right here it's like a lot lighter than like the rest. So it's like right here is red and like right here is red, so I'm gonna try and do my best to blend the rest of her nose together. I'm not sure, I think it's just the way like the shadows are, so if I go and undo this and deselect, yeah, it looks a little out of place just with the highlight there. Here's like another option which you could do is to just like elongate the highlight down to like the bridge of her nose and keep it up top to where it is. So what I could do if I wanted to is just select this highlighted part, source mode, and just paste it all the way down. So it makes it look like she has a highlight. I'm not a fan of that actually at all. So. What I don't want to do though is blend her nose so much to where it mats in with the rest of her face. I don't think I've ever had this much problem trying to adjust someone's nose or adjust the highlights. I might just leave it how it is, honestly. Because now that I think about it, the highlights kind of add another dimension to her nose, which isn't a bad idea. I do want to just adjust this part though. And go ahead and get rid of the bags under her eyes. Sample a little lower. Now, what you don't want to do is completely get rid of her bottom of her eye, because then it looks like she has no depth, and then I've actually done it so much one time that it made the girl like she had allergies. So I ended up scrapping the entire layer and just restarting from scratch. I usually go in here and just retouch the eye by sampling a different piece. The one thing you gotta watch when you're doing skin retouching or working with skin is you might select like a big patch like this and drag it over. So like I drag it over to like the lighter part. And then you have like all these little ridges like right here and like right here. You have to individually go in and just like blend those to the rest of the skin that's around it, just so it actually makes it look like the skin was actually meant to be there. I'm going to deselect this. Yeah, her skin's not bad at all. Honestly, don't have to work too much on this. Get rid of some of her lines. I usually save trying to get rid of the lines for when I do texture, but they're pretty visible in the skin section. Okay, that looks pretty good so far. I'm just gonna get rid of some more stuff. Yeah, I'm actually pretty happy with this. I normally don't delve this deep. Just get rid of a couple of like meandering things that like bug me. Most of the stuff people wouldn't even worry about. Oops, knocked my phone off the table. Okay, go ahead and deselect this. Turn my high frequency back on. And I would honestly say this looks like a clean picture. Just want to go into high frequency and just adjust where I like erase her lines. Sample that with a different patch of skin. Yeah. I honestly say since this one went by pretty fast, I'll probably end up editing another picture. Just because this was pretty simple, like pretty straightforward. There wasn't really a lot of added stuff to this one. Which are like some of my favorite pictures, but you don't have too much to edit. That doesn't look bad at all. I'm gonna go ahead and do my dodging and burning. Gonna adjust my curves. Highlights up a little bit. Go ahead and invert. Paintbrush. White color. 30 and 30. And change the brush size so it matches what I want to highlight. So I'm going to make this a little smaller for her nose. Get her chin. She has some pretty nice highlights underneath her eyes. Turn it off and on just so you see what I'm doing. I might go through and smooth out her lips. Just because there's a lot of detail on them. Oops. Group that together. Then I want to go through and adjust the darks. Go to invert. No, in case you didn't know, I use Affinity Photo to edit my pictures in. I do a really bad job of advertising that, just because I'm kind of used to like just my normal workflow and going in and doing pictures. Go ahead. Turn the brush all the way down. Pass it 30-30, and let's get to color and make sure I'm on the right layer. Like, honestly, eyebrows are probably like my least favorite thing to do, just because the way I was taught was that when you do eyebrows, you're supposed to follow the flow of the eyebrows. I'm trying to get like every hair follicle. It just makes the eyebrows look a lot more natural. Go ahead and get my eraser tool out because I messed up. Put my brush back on. Alrighty, I'm gonna turn this off and on. You see how much detail I did to her eyebrows. Her eyelashes are pretty dark, so I probably won't touch those. Yeah, go ahead and get some more skin retouching stuff that I missed. So, I'm gonna move this up here. Open this up. No, that was low, high frequency. Patch tool back on. And I like It's this little dot on the nose right here. There's a couple other things. The Affinity photo isn't perfect, but it's like pretty close. The only gripe I really have with the Affinity photo is when you have too many apps open, sometimes the app goes really slow. And if you're not using like the newest iPad Pro out there, then like the refresh rate honestly just kills everything. And it's kind of annoying. Let's see, turn this off. Yeah. I'm not gonna touch her lips. They look pretty fine. I might change the blue color on this wall. I'm not like a big fan of it. I'm actually going to all the rest of this together. So here's the original, and here's what we've done. So I just pretty much smoothed her face out. I'm thinking about brightening up this picture, so in order to do that, make sure I have the layer selected, go to adjustments, and one of these should say exposure. Or not. Nope, there it is. And I'm gonna turn it up a little bit. Turn up a lot, that's what happens. So it's like really minimal. Even just going up a little, like 0.33, that's a lot. So I'm gonna leave that there. I'm gonna turn this off and turn it back on. It does quite a bit. Which this is the exposure, and Affinity Photo is a lot more sensitive, in my opinion, than the one is on Lightroom Mobile or Lightroom in general. So from here, I'm gonna put this in here. Now, what do I wanna do? Oh, wall. So I'm just gonna go to adjustments and go down to selective color. You can also do this in HSL. I like selective color a little more. Lets me play around and figure out what I want to adjust. So from here, it's not the reds. I think it's usually cyan. If not, yeah, it is cyan. So I can make this wall like a deep blue. Navy blue is like my favorite color, and that's kind of usually my go-to. But I can make this wall like a nice teal. Make it turn on yellows. Make this like a deep blue. I don't really like the deep blue though. Make it darker. Make it a lot lighter. I might make a slider. Zero. Okay. Magenta's definitely what's gonna kill me. So I'm actually kind of a fan of this deep blue. I can also turn it down. I guess a nice teal. Teal doesn't look that bad actually. Everything away so I can. Oops. Keep the opacity all the way at 100. Kind of like that. I don't want it to paste to the rest of the picture. I'm not sure exactly what else is affecting, but I just really want to make it sure it's affecting just the door. So I'm still going to mask this. So now I'm going to go down here to adjustments, channels, and invert this. Now, here comes the really fun part. Coloring it all in. So I usually just make this like the big brush. And begin to color. And you can see the color changing. Oh, man. Okay, I'm actually going to restart this whole thing. I was wondering how I didn't see the change that hard. And I can honestly say it's because I set my opacity at 30 and my flow at 30. Now, there we go. Now, I'm just gonna go in here, turn my eraser on, go a little bigger, go on my edges over her. Oops. And just go through and erase where I got her. Now, go back to my paintbrush on and make it smaller, just so I can get in the little like cracks and nitbits. Just like outlining her and her hair.
Yeah.
I take back my earlier statement. There are no such thing as simple portraits. I didn't have to do a lot to her face, but I'm actually pretty okay with this. Turn this off, back on. That's what it looks like. So I'll go ahead and group this in with this and turn it off. So it's the original picture we're dealing with, and this is the one we finished editing, which I'm kind of proud of. So I'm gonna go ahead and export this. Share, save image, click share again. And I'm gonna go ahead and airdrop this to my computer and my phone. Oh, come on. So that's been my tutorial for the day. I'm thinking about making, I already have a Twitch account. Thank goodness I got my username that I wanted. I'm still trying to work on trying to get it from Twitter. But the hope is that I can start live streaming on Twitch and live streaming on YouTube. I'm hoping to have that up by the end of this month. So we'll say today is the 25th. So I have 5 days to get the rest of my equipment set up and get this on the road. So thank you guys for joining another video. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to, if you're watching this from Twitter, don't hesitate to DM me from Twitter. Also, do not hesitate to leave comments down below and ask me more questions. And I will see you guys in the next live stream tomorrow, or next video edit tomorrow. See ya.